Welcome to ZCast, everyone. I'm ZS Caraval from ZK Research, and I'm in Seattle in front of Climate Pledge Arena with fellow Canadian.
That's right.
John Oleck from Cisco. And tell me what your role there.
So I'm Vice President of Product Management. I oversee the contact center business.
The contact center business,
that's right.
Cisco. That's great. It's a big business for you guys now, right?
Sure, and growing.
Okay, so we're here to, we're going to go actually go see the crack in the NHL game soon. And I wanted to talk about how hockey, which we both grew up playing because we're Canadian, you have to.
Playing, watching, loving, yeah. That's right.
How hockey is similar to contact center. You might not think they're the same, but there are a lot of similarities. For instance, hockey, every arena I've been to, every CIO I've talked to from every sport is obsessed with fan experience. Fan experience drives everything. You have good fan experience, fans come back, they enjoy themselves, they spend more money.
Yep.
Similar to the contact center, customer experience is really the driving force behind the innovation now.
So absolutely.
Tell me a little bit about how what Webex does to enhance customer experience.
Absolutely. So you're totally right, Zias. I think experience is at the heart of this. Because I talk about this all the time. That arena was awesome. I hated this place. I couldn't get signal. So with Webex Contact Center, which is our brand new cloud-built platform, it starts with how do I enhance that interaction between the customer and the agent or the business? And you start with that because if it doesn't feel good, you're not coming back. Much like if tonight doesn't go well, we're not coming back. And so it is at really the forefront of what we think of as the brand of the business.
Yeah.
And so it's choice. How do I interact with you? What are the channels?
Yeah, and I had a conversation actually with the CEO of the Tampa Bay Lightning about this a little while ago. So even when the team isn't doing well, if you have a good in-arena experience, fans will come back.
That's right.
And similarly, like if a customer has a problem and they have a good experience with that brand, they may come back. Or even if you have a good product and you have a bad experience, you may not come back.
Well, and also, it could be that it was a bad experience, but if they reach out later and say, hey, we're sorry that the Wi-Fi didn't work, we're sorry about this, and offer something, that can save the day.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
All right, so CX is important and hockey fan experience is important. So
yes.
Second point, analytics, more importantly, AI-driven analytics is everything today. Right?
Yes.
And so I know in all sports, you look at they're all using analytics now to measure how fast players skate. Do they get in the corner? You know, they're looking at. In fact, one of the things I talked to the NHL about from an analytics perspective is they never used to look at things like face-off against individual players.
Yep.
They just didn't have the data. But now that's incredibly important. If you know a certain center has a matchup advantage against another one, you'll put them out there on home ice and it can create quite a big advantage.
That's right.
So,
that's right.
What is Webex doing to help its customers with AI-based analytics?
Well, I think you really hit at it, right? It's, first of all, you have to have the right data. Second, data changes. The things you want to collect and understand are different. Much like you just said, now we understand face-off win rates. We, in a contact center, don't just think about, well, what's the average handle time of this agent, but in fact, what topics are they good at? To your point about AI, understanding what the problem was, the intent, how it went, and then surfacing that, because maybe that's the right agent in the future to handle this. Or if it's a high volume problem, maybe that's a virtual agent problem, not a human agent problem, and you adapt as you go. It is not a static picture.
Yeah, one of the things that, again, in my conversation with the NHL and other sports CIOs said is, what AI can do is it can help the untrained eye see things that the trained eye can see.
Yes.
And so even from a fan perspective, if you're watching a game, and if you're a casual fan, you may not know what's going on.
Right, right.
But if they put up on the screen that a certain player has lost 82% of the face-offs against this person, you might watch that a little bit harder, and that creates that little bit of tension that you need to make the game a little bit more exciting.
That's right.
Similarly for a brand, I suppose they can use AI to understand things. The agent now can understand things they may not have known before, correct?
That's right. It is time to understanding, therefore time to action, right? So something about, it used to be you had to watch over a TV to hear the commentator discuss this, and then you go, oh, I didn't realize that, right? To your point, it's something I didn't know before, now I can act on it. Same thing, AI in front of the human agents, in front of the business analyst, means they can have the aha moment and take a corrective action or do more of a good thing.
And tell me about some of the AI-based capabilities that the agent now has that were just announced.
Absolutely, so we have a couple things here that I think really changed the game. So we have agent answers, but not just your traditional search. It's what is the ongoing conversation right now? What's the sentiment of the customer? How am I going to adapt the fact so the customer gets it best? You might want a deep technical answer for something. I might want a super simple one. And so really translating that to, well, what is the thing I should say right now is key. Another one actually is the flip side. As these conversations are happening, how are they going? To your point, shortening that time for the supervisor to understand and coach the agent. So you know what? You really shouldn't say this to this kind of customer in this situation. Again, elevating that experience, which we already said was at the core of this. And the key, AI drives it to faster understanding, right? You're not having an analyst look at this 3 days later. I can do it right now, surface to a supervisor that says, go here. And the third one that I think is really cool actually is about the experience itself. So we take pride in our background noise reduction and removal. Right. Meaning if you're out here right now standing in line and talking to an agent because your ticket's not working, we pull all that background noise out. So I, the agent, can hear you and you're already stressed, right? You're frustrated and I don't say, yes, could you say that again? I didn't catch that. So those are some examples of the AI advancements we've made with our Webex Contact Center.
You know, your background noise removal is almost too good in some cases. I had a video that I did in a pretty noisy place.
Yeah.
And I ran it through Webex to eliminate the background noise. And I used the Optimize for My Voice feature.
Yes.
Right? And it eliminated all the noise except my voice.
Yeah.
And it was like, you should have had some background noise. So
yep.
I can attest to the fact that it's really good, almost too good in some cases.
Yeah, we are proud of that one for sure.
Yeah, yeah. So anyways, just like I said that the AI can help the fan, the untrained eye see,
yes.
you know, see things that the trained eye sees. Similarly, I guess it can help the agent understand things that a trained agent might have.
Absolutely. Yeah. It's all of the people involved in delivering on that customer experience we can make better. Right, again, time to understanding, therefore time to action.
Yeah. So the third point I wanted to bring up is that coaching matters. Right, in the NHL, you have a good coach, you're going to, you know, you'll largely be successful. You have a bad coach. But even coaching has changed. Coaching's become much more data-driven, right? Where historically it might have been sort of look and feel, gut feel-driven. I know in the contact center historically, the way you coached, and for those that aren't familiar with contact center, this lasted a long time. You would have a coach literally walk around the contact center and listen for calls that have gone awry.
Over the shoulder, right?
Yeah. But today there's a lot more data for the manager,
that's right?
To help him coach. Talk about that.
So actually, I love this because it ties to hockey as well. Back in the day, you had a playbook. You had five plays, everyone learned them, and then you say play one, play four, play three, play five. Data means that you can better adapt, right? Make that decision, say, no, scrap that, we're gonna do this instead, right? Similar with contact center, providing that depth of understanding, everything from how the conversation's going, is the customer happy? Is the agent saying the right things? Means that I can jump in now, or better yet, the AI is jumping in and giving that hint to the agent, you shouldn't go down this path, right? This is not an easy conversation. And then we change the play. We find a different way to approach the problem and ultimately solving the customer's problem, right? And
yeah, in fact, one of the things that's impressed me is a lot of the data that you give to the manager matters more than ever now because you do have remote agents.
Yes.
Where historically, even today, if you wanted to have that agent, that manager walk around and listen to, you can't do it anymore
that's
unless you're going to go visit everybody at their home, right?
That's right. The hybrid work story applies equally to customer experience and contact centers as it does to what we think of as knowledge workers and back office.
Yeah, in fact, maybe more so.
Yes, absolutely.
So point four I wanted to bring up is the need to modernize. I think, and this, you know, it's open to some debate in hockey, I suppose, that you can have a lot of old school coaches think that the old way works. But by and large, every great coach has their time in the sun and then the game passes them by.
Yep.
Similarly, I think with contact centers, there's a lot of companies I know still running old on-prem systems thinking good enough is good enough. But that's not the case anymore, right?
Right.
So how is the Webex Contact Center different? How is it more modern?
Yeah, actually, so I'm going to start with the analogy back to hockey, right? You look at the kids that just broke onto the scene back in 99 versus today. Today they're skating faster, they understand better, they're adapting to the sport much better than before. Same with contact center. Back in the day, you would have a massive deployment on premises. You would have your IT folks manage this, patch this, roll this. Today, you need the agility of a cloud-based contact center like Webex Contact Center, where we're running all that for you. We're bringing you the latest and greatest in digital, in data, and in AI. So you're thinking about how do I adapt this to my need instead of how do I run this thing, right? That's at the core of value of why the cloud. And just like hockey, you should focus on the game, not the individual pieces that make up the play.
Yeah, so coaching matters, but data-driven coaching.
Absolutely.
Okay. And the last point I wanted to bring up is sustainability. And that's not something you typically associate with pro sports, or any sports for that matter, but we are in front of Climate Pledge Arena, and it is a lot of people don't know this, but it's the only sporting facility in the world that's carbon neutral.
That's
net zero. So kudos to the Kraken for making that happen. How does a cloud-based contact center, a Webex contact center, help companies with sustainability goals?
Well, I think there's kind of two levels to this, right? Sustainability is something we all have to be responsible for. It could be that, yes, I used to run these data centers. I knew my footprint. It's someone else's cloud. It's not my problem. That's not true. So a vendor like Cisco, we take this seriously because it is impact. as we move more to digital, move more to these cloud-based services, and AI coming on board, it's just going to exacerbate this problem. And so sustainability, to us, is a top-line problem for us to solve, right? And how we run our cloud, how do we optimize so we're not just burning cycles, burning, unfortunately, in some cases, fossil fuel to generate that electricity, instead being responsible, delivering value to customer as well as the business and the environment.
Yeah, and sustainability, in fact, is a big initiative, not just within the Context Center group, but Cisco in general. It's very aggressive net zero goals.
Absolutely.
In fact, I just saw your purpose report that came out, and there's a lot of great data points around the circular economy and all the things Cisco's doing from a recycling perspective all the way down to suppliers and its partners.
Right, our devices as our cloud service, right? It's across the board that we think about this.
Yeah. And so just like the Kraken have thought about sustainability holistically across the team and the stadium, Cisco's thought about that as a company.
That's right.
All right, Jono, well, thanks for joining me. Anything else you want to add?
Go Kraken.
Yeah, so we're going to go see the Kraken play the Kings. Any predictions tonight?
Yeah, we're going to win.
Okay.
Don't hold me to that, but I think we will.
Well, that's good. So as a kid who grew up in Vancouver, or near Vancouver, being a Canucks fan, never was a big Kings fan, so.
I know.
Go Kraken.
That's right.
All right.
Thanks, Zias.
Thanks for joining me, Jono.
Yep.
And for those of you watching, thanks for watching. Please hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you next time on another ZCast.